Good morning, children. Today we are discussing about structure of typical power. Structure of a typical flower. In that we know very well. First, we are going to discuss about calyx. Calyx. What is calyx? Calyx remains attached. Okay, calyx remains attached. Very, very important to the base. Calyx remains attached to the base. Okay. Now, what we are doing is, okay, attached to the base of the thalamus. Next, and forms the outermost wall. All of a flower. The whole constitutes the individual units called sepals. The functions of sepals is to protect the flower. Okay, children, this is important. When it is in the form of bud. This is important, children. Okay, next, another important one. What you are discussing is corolla. What is that? Corolla. The inner wall of a flower lying inside a sepal called corolla. Sepals called corolla. The individual units of corolla is called
petals.
What do you call petals? Next, petals are generally very, very important. Petals are generally large, showy and brightly colored to attract the insect pollination. Next, insect pollinators. Okay, what are called insect pollinators? This is important. Next, calyx and corolla. Calyx and corolla are non-essential parts of flower. Non-essential parts of flower because they are not directly involved in the reproduction. That is important. Okay, children. Next, andrecium. What is andrecium? Andrecium are also called stamen. Andrecium constitutes the individual units called stamen. Okay, the individual units called stamens. This is important. Next, stamens are the male reproductive. Stamens are the male reproductive organ of a plant. Stamen are the male reproductive organs of a plant. Okay, next, which forms the third whorl of a flower. This is important. Next, there will be several stamens present in a flower. Next, a single stamen is made up of how many parts? Two parts. What are the two parts? Number one, a stalk and anther. Stalk, number two, anther. Like this, two parts will be there. Okay, children, observe very carefully. We are discussing the structure of a typical flower. So, you know very well, the reproductive unit in the plant is the flower. Both two types of flowers are there. Unisexual flowers, bisexual flowers. So, flower is the reproductive unit. So, in that flower, some important parts we are going to discuss. The flower consists of, number one, calyx. Calyx remains attached to the base of the thalamus. And forms the outermost whorl of a flower. First point. Calyx remains attached to the base of the thalamus. So, you need, this is the base. This particular part is calyx. This is the base. Forms the outermost whorl. Next, of a flower. The outermost whorl constitutes the individual units. You know, green color in the flower rose, the individual units called sepals. What do you call? The calyx contains the individual units called sepals. The function of sepals is to protect the flower when it is in the form of a bud. The function of sepals is to protect the flower when it is in the form of a bud. Next, come to corolla. The inner wall of a flower lying inside sepals called corolla. The inner wall of a flower lying inside sepals. Inside the sepals, there will be corolla will be present. The individual units of corolla is called. The individual units of corolla is called petals. Petals are generally large, showy, and brightly colored to attract which one? Insect pollinators. Okay, what is pollinator? Which helpful for the exchange of the pollen grains. Pollination means the transfer of the pollen grains from anther to stigma. So insects will be involved in the pollination process. Two such kind of insect attractions. Compulsory, the bright color petals required. The petals main important thing is large, show and brightly colored to attract the which one? Insect pollinators. The calyx and corolla. What do you call? The calyx and corolla are non-essential parts. Non-essential means not that much useful parts, but useful but not that much essential. The flower, because they are not directly. Why we are calling not a non-essential? Why? Because they are not involved in the which process? Reproduction process. They are not involving in the reproduction process. Next, come to the another important part we are discussing, that is andrisium. So andrisium, also called stamen. Andrisium consists the individual units called. So in the andrisium, male reproductive part, the andrisium constitute the individual units called stamens. Stamens are the male reproductive organ of a plant, which form the third wall of a flower. Third wall. So first one is calyx, second one is what you call corolla. The third wall is a stamens of a flower. There may be several stamens in a flower. Several stamens in a flower. A single stamen is made up of two parts. Number one, stalk. Number two, anther. So stalk and anther will be there. A single stamen only is made up of two parts. Stalk and anther. We are discussing what is stalk and what is anther. We are going to discuss. Okay, children, observe very carefully. We are discussing about andrisium. In that stamen, the stamen contains two parts. What are the two parts? You know very well. The typical flower. Come on. What is a stalk? Andrisium. Okay. In the andrisium, we are discussing about stamen. The stamen consists of two parts. Number one is stalk. What is stalk? Which is the filamentous part, which is the filamentous part. Number one. And another important one of stamen, filamentous part of the stamen. Okay, children, the second one, filamentous part of the stamen, right? And anther. And anther. Okay. A swollen bilobed structure. A swollen bilobed structure will be there. That is called anther. A swollen bilobed structure. That is called which one? Anther. Attached to the distal end of the stalk. End anthers, and each anther, each anther bears four, what you called, very important, inner chambers, four inner chambers called, or inner chambers called pollen sacs. Pollen sacs are what you called microsporangia. Microsporangia. This is important. Okay. Next, inside microsporangia. What you called inside the microsporangia. Inside the microsporangia. What you called inside the microsporangia are present numerous. What you called numerous, very important, numerous pollens. What you called pollens are present. Pollen produces male gametes, number one, number two, which remains present in the form of a yellow powder called pollen grains. Very important word. Next, gynoecium. The next part is gynoecium. It is also called carpel. Gynoecium is also called carpel. Carpel or pistil is the female reproductive organs. Female reproductive organ of a plant. Okay, next, carpel is next word we are going to discuss about. The carpel is situated. Carpel is situated in the, where it's situated, in the center of the flower. Situated in the center of the flower as a flask shaped structure
will be there.
This is important. Next, a carpel is made up of what you call three parts. How many parts? Three parts. Number one, stigma. Number two, style. Number three, stigma, style. And another one is ovary. Stigma, style, and ovary. Next, the distal part of a carpel is called stigma. The distal part of a carpel is called stigma. Stigma is responsible for receiving pollen during pollination. The next important style is the style. Okay, style is the middle part. Style is the middle part. Okay, style is the middle part of carpal. Style is the middle part of the carpal. It is an what you called elongated tubular structure. Okay, elongated tubular structure which connects the stigma with the ovary, which connects stigma with ovary. Stigma with the ovary, very very important. Okay children, observe very carefully. We are discussing about structure of a typical flower. So in that andrecium, we discussed male reproductive part. Andrecium consists of unit stamen, the stamen consists of stalk, which is the filamentous part, like filament part of the stamen. And anther is a swollen, what you call swollen bulb, a swollen bilobed structure attached to the distal end of the stalk. Each anther bears four inner chambers. How many chambers each anther have? Four inner chambers called pollen sacs. What you call pollen sacs are microsporangia. Once again children, andrecium is a male reproductive part which contains the stamen. The stamen consists of different two parts. Number one is a stalk, which is the filamentous part of the stamen, and anther, a swollen bilobed structure attached to the distal end of the stalk. Each anther bears four internal or inner chambers called pollen sacs or microsporangia. Next, inside the microsporangia are present many number of pollens are there. This pollen produces male gametes, which remains present in the form yellow powder. Which pollens are yellow form? That called yellow form powder called pollen grains. What you call pollen grains? Once again, inside the microsporangia are present numerous pollens. Pollen produce male gametes, which remains present in form yellow powder called pollen grains. Next, come to gynoecium. Gynoecium or carpel. Gynoecium is also called carpel. Carpel or pistil is the female reproductive organ of a plant. So male reproductive part is andrecium, female reproductive part is gynoecium. So the carpel is situated in the center of the flower. As flask shaped structure. A carpel is made up of three parts. Stigma, style, ovary. The distal part of a carpel is called stigma. First part, stigma is responsible for, what is the use of stigma? Responsible for receiving pollen during pollination. So stigma will receive the pollen grains. Style is the middle part of carpel. It is an elongated tube. So style is the elongated tubular structure which connects the stigma with the ovary. So tomorrow we will discuss about the ovary and other parts of the flower. Okay children, this is the gynoecium. Carpel or pistil in the female reproductive organ of a plant. Carpel is situated in center of the flower as a flask shaped structure. A carpel is made up of three parts, stigma, style and ovary. The distal part of a carpel is called stigma. Stigma function what? Responsible for receiving pollen during pollination. Style is the middle part of the carpel. It is an elongated tubular structure which connects the stigma with the ovary. Thank you children. Thank you very much.